Hi guys, this is Catch Carp Hungary TV. This time we are at Paradise Lake and it's a really a special edition what we have because we had a week session with the living legend, Mr. Steve Briggs, who is here with us. Welcome, Steve, to Hungary, first of all.
Well, thank you very much. It's lovely to be here and, we've had a great week, haven't we?
Definitely. I mean, like, you know, big moments what we have, a really intensive week. We might have like one day or two when it was a bit more quiet, but the rest was quite full of action. What was your favorite moment?
Well, there was many highlights. I mean, right. Every day we had action and we got it all on film, which would be great to show the guys in a minute. But I guess the highlight really had to be quite early on with the big common. 25 kilo common, which was a real surprise. I didn't expect that at all. I really didn't. So that was the biggest surprise.
You guys have to know that actually that common is the biggest carp in this year so far from this lake, and Mr. Briggs just managed it on his second day to catch it. So really well done. But there are many other moments, you know, which we put on the camera, filmed it, and I think you will really enjoy the video. So keep watching and have fun.
Well, this is something a little bit different. I'm out in Hungary this week, a place called Paradise Lakes. And I was invited out by a really nice Hungarian guy, Attila Pinke. And, conversation's been going on for about a year or so, but finally I've got here anyway, and, I'm pleased I've come here now. It's actually really nice here, and it's a nice lake. It's about 40 acres, the lake, with a string of islands going up the middle of it. There's loads of carp in here, for sure, I know that. And they go up to sort of, from what I can work out, low to mid-60s, but there seems to be quite a few sort of over 20 kilos anyway, 44 pound, you know, between 44 and 50. There seems to be quite a few of those. And I mean, it looks like it's, you know, a lake where you get a bit of action with the chance of a big one anyway. So, you know, fingers crossed that's going to happen. I suppose it's quite a commercial lake for Hungary. There's 14 swims on here and each one's got a cabin. You don't bivvy up here as such, you get a cabin. There's four beds in each cabin, and you can have the swim, you know, each swim for two or three people, really. You can have a maximum of six rods per swim, so you could have six rods out for one person if you like, or if there's three of you fishing, you know, it's two rods each. It works out like that. It's just me in this cabin here anyway, and you know, I've got the week on here, and it looks really nice. So you know, the rods are out and fishing various different spots out there at the moment. It's doesn't vary that much out there. It drops down in the edge to sort of 5.5-6 foot, and it seems to be pretty much that all the way across the lake. You know, varies up and down a slight bit. So I'm going to try different areas, different baits, and see how I get on. But yeah, it's looking nice.
So strong, unbelievable. Lots of action though, it's all happening. Oh mate. Still strong. Points Well, it's been a fantastic morning. I think we've had, must be 8 fish between us now. But they're so strong, it's unbelievable. I mean, this fish really fought hard for, must be 20 minutes, and he's still angry. He was 8.8 kilos, and a long, lean fighting machine, and I've been so impressed. I mean, the condition of these fish is fantastic, and the fighting qualities, and need to be a good goalkeeper with these ones. But, I'm well impressed. I mean, I was just saying to Attila yesterday morning that the one thing I haven't had for a while, it's a nice action, you know, consistent action, where I haven't had to wait a day or 2 days for a bite, you know, to get 3 or 4 in the morning. And, well, that's 6 runs this morning now. And this isn't the biggest one, but he was certainly the hardest fighting. But it's incredible. The fishing is incredible quality. And I know there's more out there, so I'm going to have to get this one back and get the rods back out, because there's more to come, I'm sure. And I think he wants to go back as well, so we're getting back and get the rods out.
Here we go. Off you go, sunshine. Lovely. God. It's brilliant stuff. Come on.
Really enjoying this. Excellent fishing. Feel a bit worn out though. Need a rest and a cup of tea, I think.
This was my wake-up call in the morning. Nice mirror. Oh, very strong one. What a lovely fish. Beautiful. I coated it with 2 pieces of tiger nut and a little plastic cone on the top.
Well, this is a little bit different. This is the particle mix that they sell on site here at Paradise Lakes. And the fish get to see a lot of this. It goes in every week and it's what they sell. Most of the anglers buy some of this, and I've got to say, you know, I've been using a bit of this and it certainly works. And it's got all sorts of stuff in it. Normal maize, I mean, there's tigers in there, little bits of hemp, not so much. But there's also these large beans, and this is like the giant maize, giant corn, various other beans. So, you know, it's basically a very large particle mix. I mean, there are other small species in here, roach and bream, a few tench. I've got to say, I haven't seen any of them really, but you know, this is obviously designed just to target the carp. And yeah, like I say, it's different to what we've seen before. I've not seen particles sort of used in this way, like a giant particle mix, but you know, it's what they use here and it certainly works. So yeah, maybe it's something I'll look into in the future, but the carp here like it anyway.
Oh, he's a nice one.
don't know what he weighs. I haven't looked yet. Wow. Let's have a look. I've got to have a look. Oh, yeah. 25. Oh, unbelievable. Wow. 54 and a half pounds. 25 kilo. Yes. Oh. Oh, amazing, amazing. That is brilliant. Oh, I'm just caught in the edge on a little pop-up right in the edge. That is just brilliant, amazing. Wow, God. It's good here. I love this lake. Paradise Lake is absolutely fantastic. Wow. What is that? Wow. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Well, it's been a fantastic morning, it really has. And I don't know how many fish that is now, I think it's 9. And I came here hoping that maybe I could get a 20 kilo fish or an English 40, you know, like an 18 kilo, 19 kilo. Well, this one's just blown that out of the water, 25.3 kilo, which is 55.12. And it's, well, it's just amazing. One of the big ones for sure. And just from the margin, that's the amazing thing. We expected a big one maybe to come from the middle and come from 2 meters from the bank on a little pop-up. Whoa. And there we go, look at that. What a fantastic fish. 55 pound 12 ounce Hungarian common carp, and I didn't expect to see it, but I'm so pleased this one came along because it is absolutely fantastic. It really is. Like I say, a little pop up 2 meters from the bank, just a few meters from where I'm standing now, and well, what a fantastic result. Oh, 25 kilo, it's absolutely amazing. What a lovely fish. Absolutely brilliant. Well pleased with that. That's the trip made. I think there's more to come, but if this is the last fish, it'll be great. Fantastic.
I have already a carp in my waist sling, a very nice one, above 20 kilo, and my another rod went off. Amazing, after a slow day, and 2 runs now in 10 minutes. Is 21.9. Yeah, 21.9 kilo. Yeah, great job. Awesome. Yeah, very happy. So, after a half a day of silence, I got a monster, a real big one. This one is above 20 kilo, 21.9, beautiful fella. Check it out, a real good one. Awesome big fish. Okay, look at this big belly. It's very difficult to... Right, I think it's tired, I'm tired. Lovely, just 2 pieces of little tiger nut and a plastic cone. That was it. Nice, time to put it back. Well, I'm really happy.
Yes, great.
Well, it's a beautiful sunny day, and there is another little pond next to this lake. And there are nice koi, so we thought we just, you know, reel in and go over and have fun and figure out if we might can catch some, yeah? So, shall we?
I think so. We'll give it a go. It's quiet here, so a couple of hours should be fun.
Yeah, okay, let's do it. Yeah, let's do it. Yeah, we just here at this little pond, but the wind getting very strong, and if you look at the back, there are like pretty bad clouds also, so we might get a couple of runs, but then we really have to go back and find some shelter before we get so wet. Okay, so let's start quick.
Absolutely screaming run. Wow. I've actually took my lead off now. I'm freelining just with the tungsten tubing. And well, same as usual. A few seconds it was there and away. It nearly took off out the lake.
Big, but he sure is beautiful. What a lovely fish. Then I was crumbling up some 4G squid in the edge. There was one or two coming in. Gradually there was more and more, and they were actually taking the bits of boilie on the drop. And I couldn't believe that it didn't go off sooner. But sure enough, it went off, and well, look at that. What a stunning little carp. Absolutely gorgeous. Don't have to be big when they look like that. That's the saying, as it goes, and it's so true. Beautiful little car. And good fun.
Well, one little choddy, free line. And look at this colorful one. What a koi. And the rain just started. And the wind is blowing. Everything is going on. Lovely. From this little pond. Amazing. As you can see my boilie, some kind of whitefish or little catfish really tried to eat it. So I think I will change it now to tiger nut, because that sounds to me a better solution against them, and maybe it will last longer. So give it a try. So as I said, this will be my rig, you know, tiger nut, and topped up with a little plastic cone. Very simple rig, you know, fangfish the hook with a little silicon tube at the end, about, let's say, 25 centimeter long. Yeah, that's it. I already caught the biggest fish on this one so far, so with tiger nut, and yeah, hopefully the little catfish and the whitefish won't, you know, eat this one like the boilie.
It's a bit of a hectic 10 minutes, and probably a little bit longer for the fish, because I had a few bleeps earlier on one rod, and I thought, well, I'll just replace it because something's happened. Sure enough, the fish on the longer range rod had it gone around the snag, a branch out in the middle, and had doubled back and had come back virtually into my margin, which hadn't really registered. So when I went out, line doubled back. But anyway, I've got the fish, and it's a nice 15 kilo mirror. Actually a beautiful fish. Then literally just as we got that one in, another rod went off with about 11 kilo cobbin on the end. So it was a little bit hectic to say the least, but it all ended up well. We got both fish on the bank, and well, like I say, this was the pick of the two, a lovely 15 kilo mirror. So I haven't had many mirrors. Most of my fish here have been commons. But there we go. This is one of the better ones. A lovely dark 15 kilo mirror. Fantastic stuff. Well pleased with that.
I just got a bit of action in the middle of the night. So it was a great fight. It went into the reed, so I had to get after it by boat. It's a lovely mirror, 15.7 kilo. Another beautiful carp from Paradise Lake. So here's my next carp. Really surprised me, because it's a real beauty. It was just like a, you know, usual common or mirror or something. It's a beautiful koi carp, about, well, almost 8 kilo, I would say. check this beauty. Very nice. I'm really happy to catching it. Made my day really special.
It's funny, you know, because I brought with me my usual sort of travelling away kit and thinking, you know, Hungarian waters are going to be pretty similar to French and so forth. So, you know, I brought with me some big hard hook baits, normal 4G squid and everything. And it's turned out the most successful rig at the moment is a little hinge rigged pop-up, which is quite strange because, I mean, how it worked out, when I brought my reels out with me, I had my old rigs on from my English fishing, which I'd been up on Acton Vernell, and I'd caught a few fish on the hinge rigs up there with little pop-ups, and of course I chucked these off when I got here in favour of my other sort of bottom bait and snowman rigs. And then I thought, well, I don't know, this lake does remind me a little bit of an English style lake, if you like, so I thought, well, why not just try a little hinge rig pop-up out there, you know. Sure enough, put it out and off it went, and now it's been the most successful rig. I should think I've caught, well, I've had 15 fish I think so far, and probably 10 of those have been on this little hinge rig, you know, mainly just down the margin spot. Little 4G squid pop-up, fluorocarbon boom, and you know, the chod link hook section. But there we go, you just never know, do you? You know, I mean, most of me continental fishing is done with sort of stronger gear, bigger baits, bigger, harder baits, you know. And turns out the English style fishing has come out on top at the moment with the little hinge rig pop up. So there we go, as long as something's working, you know, it's just a matter of finding what it is. And at the moment, this is it. Well, incredible fight, lovely looking fish, and heavy too. Yeah, it's 41 and a half pounds. Fantastic. What a lovely fish. I'm worn out. Oh, I've got no strength left. God, fantastic fish. Well, it was a tough fight for sure, but as it was coming in, we saw a glow of sort of white and yellow, and well, there we go. That's what was on the end. What a fish, eh? That is absolutely incredible fish. My biggest koi, ghosty, whatever you want to call them. It was 18.8 kilos, so about 41.5, 41.12. We'll have to check in a minute. But, you know, a glorious fish. Absolutely gorgeous fish. Pulled my arms off, it did. Absolutely pulled my arms off. On the little margin spot again. And, well, it's turning out to be a great session. We've both had big fish. Attila's literally just put a 15 kilo mirror, a 21.8 kilo common back, heard my alarm, and this was on the end. What an evening's fishing. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Fantastic, absolutely fantastic, isn't it? What a place.
I think it was a action-full video with many really big carps and beautiful moments. You know, I have really nice memories. It was great to watch back these pictures, even if it just happened a week ago, a couple of days ago. I think I will always remember these, I believe so.
We had action every day, and we've managed to compress it into one video, but it was brilliant, wasn't it? The whole, every day, something special happened, so it was great.
For sure, definitely. You know, finally, anything to add just to the end, if you want to say something?
Well, I guess I'd just like to say thank you very much for everything.
You're very welcome.
Catch Carp Hungary, well, you've looked after me so well. The service has been brilliant. The tackle you provide, actually, has been brilliant. So all in all, it's made the week just extra special. So I'd just like to say thank you for everything, because it was brilliant.
It was, you know, our pleasure to have you here, and you are really welcome. And for you guys, if you like this video, then please subscribe our YouTube channel for the freshest news. Follow us on our Facebook site, Twitter site, and Google Plus site. And for more information, or even booking for this lake, go on www.catchcarphungary.com. And don't forget, if you want to catch big carps in Hungary, then contact us, Catch Carp Hungary. Sightlines, see you next time. Bye, and thanks, Steve.
Cheers.
Cheers.